I do get some calls from people who ask whether their septic tanks can be converted into a biodigester. And then I have to explain to them the key differences and sometimes the conditions that you must meet in case you want to consider the construction of a biodigester or you want to convert your septic tank into a biodigester. But the truth is, you cannot convert your septic tank into a biodigester, and I'm going to give you a few reasons right here in this video. So because most people consider that the biodigester is not something they can trust, it's a new technology, they've heard stories about them, and they are not very conversant with the technology, they also do not trust the technology, they will go ahead and construct a septic tank because that's what they have grown, they've known over the years, and that's a technology that has worked for them over the years. But then their mindset is that if it doesn't work, then they will give it a try and try and convert it into a biodigester. I mean, this is coming from the background that probably they've seen some of my videos that shows us replacing a septic tank with a biodigester, right? Wrong. Key issue here you have to understand is that if you do consider a septic tank right now and you want to tomorrow convert it to a biodigester, the question is it possible? And the answer is no. The reason is the two technologies are symmetrically opposed to each other, so it is not going to work. Some of the reasons are the fact that the size and depth of a biodigester is in no way similar to a septic for you to be converted to work. When you are constructing a septic tank, you know you are getting a holding tank, which means that the water and the human waste are all going to be together in the same place. You probably get a soakaway attached to it and then hoping that some of the water, the black water, will seep there. But then the key part is the time will come you might need to have it dislodged because then it might overfill the tank and then you have to be taken out for another one to be used. And that's where sometimes the problem is. Some people do the septic tanks and realize that there's a lot of water in it. Water is coming, seeping in from the ground, probably because of the how high the water table is, and then there's nothing they can do about it. And then they are thinking of having it converted into a biodigester. So the issue is, it's not going to be possible. Like I said, the septic tank is a holding tank, which means that it's intended to hold the wastewater plus the solid. The biodigester is not. The biodigester, as I've shown in several of my videos, does the rapid separation, which happens in such a way that the water is taken out immediately you flush from the human waste. So the key understanding immediately is that depth is not an issue. That's why a biodigester can be constructed in a waterlogged area because it's not going to go down to meet the water table. If the water table is 3 feet, a biodigester can be done at 2 feet. The footing of the building is higher, then you know that your biodigester can come up enough for you to have that groom, that elevation, that separation, that will make sure that the water is taken out whenever you do flush. In this case, most of the time, what I advise homeowners who are interested in biodigesters and they think that they can convert their septic tank to biodigester is that a separate digester will have to be done and the pipes will have to be terminated, and then the digester will have to be done either at the side or at the place whereby there's enough elevation for the pipes, inlet pipes, to come and then into work. So if you ask me and you think you don't trust the technology right now, but you are going to do a septic tank, if it does not work, you have to convert it to a biodigester. You'll be throwing your money away and then you'll be wasting your resources. Your best bet is to always get somebody who is good at what they do, and people are there who can help you answer this question and give you a solution when it comes to biodigesters. Because if you do the septic tank and tomorrow you decide you're not going to use that one, you need a biodigester, three key things might happen. You'll be forced to change your toilet seats. Secondly, you'll be forced to rearrange or relay all the pipes. And thirdly, you might need additional pipes because probably you cannot do the digester at a particular location which you might want it, which means that it's going to cost you more, and then the tank will just become useless because you cannot use it for anything, and then you have to destroy it. So try and meet the terms in terms of what are the conditions that will make a biodigester work for you now, and try and solve that situation before you do consider a biodigester construction. My only advice is, if you doubt the effectiveness of a biodigester and you still want to consider it, get a traditional soakaway attached to the digester. It lasts longer, it protects your investment. The next video showing you will explain further the importance of having a soakaway attached to your biodigester.